This class we will discuss about shipyard. I will be discussing about PPR. PPR means preliminary project report. There are various stages for development of any harbor facility for a shipyard. You have to prepare a preliminary project report. We can also call this as a techno-economic feasibility report. Then we have to prepare a detailed project report, that is called as DPR. Then we have to get the clearance from the Ministry of Environment and Forest, for which many studies are to be carried out. So initially I will give what is the status of shipyards in India. Then I will give a project which is proposed near Cuddalore, and it is not taken up very seriously now, but I will tell what are the steps that has been carried out for this shipyard. The contents of today's presentation will be present scenario of the Indian shipbuilding, the project objective, what are the studies and investigation carried out, how to plan the shipyard, how to implement the project. There will be different phases of implementation, the layout of the shipyard, environmental impact assessment, which is called as EIA. Major systems and components in a shipyard. The present scenario of the Indian shipbuilding is not good. I am working on the shipyard project for the last 10 years. They will say the shipyard will come to India, it is not coming. All of you know the automobile industry is booming in India, but the shipyard is not. There are many reasons. Now the market is very bad. There are only 26 Indian shipyards as against 326 Chinese shipyards. This number is very bad. How many research parks are there in India? How many are in India research parks? You know what is a research park? Do we have a research park?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We are the only people who have the research park. You don't know that. Chinese have more than 300 research parks. Out of these 26 Indian shipyards, only 2 shipyards, that is Cochin Shipyard Limited, Cochin, and Hindustan Shipyard Limited, Visakhapatnam, capable to build ships of size greater than 40,000 DWT. Greater than means don't think it is very much larger. I think it can go up to 60,000 DWT. Are slightly more. All other ships are shipyards are very small shipyards. The shipyards are required not only for shipbuilding for commercial operations, but also for navy. We have to build nuclear submarines also. So strategically, we need more shipyards. And the last point is Indian shipyard can cater only 10% of the total domestic demand. We are not even fulfilling our domestic demand. See, whereas for car and all we are exporting, whereas we are not able to build the ship for our own self. That is a very pathetic situation. The project objective for this particular shipyard project is they want to build 28 ships per year. That means almost 2.5 ships or 2 to 3 ships per month. The size range is from 40,000 DWT to very large crude carrier, that is up to 200,000 DWT. The shipyards provide direct employment of 5,000 persons and indirect of 10,000 persons. In addition, it growth of ancillary industries of steel, electromechanical, hardware, electronics, etc. And about 500,000 tons of steel will be fabricated per year. This is what the proposal is. So you are showing the India map, the Tamil Nadu map. Tamil Nadu, there is a district, Cuddalore, where there is a cluster of facilities that will be built along this coastal line. I will explain the cluster here. There are 4 clusters that are shown here. See, one of the cluster is for Cuddalore Port Company, that is Cuddalore Power Company, that is what is shown here. Then we have Nagarjuna Oil Corporation Limited, that is Thiruchirappuram. Nagarjuna is building a refinery project. For this project, there is a jetty which is built for export of clean cargo, that is petrol, oil and petrol and clean products. Then we have a single buoy mooring system here. This is import the crude oil. This project is going on. The Cuddalore Power Company also, we want to have a jetty to import coal. Then we have a common port facility for many power plant projects that are proposed here. Then we would like to have a shipbuilding yard somewhere here. This is called as a Silambi Mangalam. This is the place where we want to have a shipyard which was planned here. So, this is a power company, Cuddalore Power Company, which imports coal. For that they planned a jetty. This is Thiruchirappuram, where we have Nagarjuna refinery, where we have a jetty for export of petroleum products. Then we have a single buoy mooring systems, from where bigger size vessels will come and import the crude oil to the refinery, and refinery will process and they will export petrol using this. Then we want to develop a common port. This common port will be for many power plants which are situated inland. Then at Silambi Mangalam, they want to plan a shipyard. Further south, there is another power plant, that project also has been sanctioned. This is what you are seeing is the coastal line. This what you are seeing is the national highway. What you are seeing here is the railway line. So, this railway line and road line is very important for projects. One of the reason many plants are developed here is lot of lands available, not agriculture lands. This is taken from naval hydrographic chart, and this line shows 10 meter contour. This line shows 20 meter contour. That means the water depth is around 20 meters, and this line shows 5 meter contour, and this is your shoreline. The distance to 5 meter contour is very small here compared to many projects, and I will show an enlarged figure later on. This is for the coal terminal facility what is planned here. When you want to develop the preliminary project report PPR, you have to identify the site location, topography, bathymetry, shipyard layout and transport network. These are the various studies that are required. Topography means the survey on the land, bathymetry means survey on the sea. We have to plan the shipyard layout, because we have to import the materials and we have to cut the steel plates, bend it, fabricate the ship and then launch the ship. So, painting and other ancillary requirements also are there. You have to plan the layout for the shipyard. I will not be going in detail about the shipyard layout, because this mainly we will be concentrating on the harbor requirements for the shipyard. First, we have to prepare the technical feasibility report. There is another report called as techno-economic feasibility. So, technical feasibility means whether the project is possible or otherwise. The next is techno-economical feasibility, that means we have to find out the cost and see whether we will be able to do the project with sufficient profit. When you talk about this technical feasibility report, mainly we have to study the wave, wind and current. This is what is required. So, last class we have seen how to study the wave and current. Along with current, we have to do the tide also. One more lecture I will give about the wind. Then we do what is known as a seismic profiling. Seismic profiling means they will do a survey, seismic survey, based on which they will be able to identify what are the types of soil below the seabed. It will not give in depth detail. You have to do a marine borehole soil investigation to do that. But seismic profiling may be a 2 kilometer by 2 kilometer area, they will be able to get what will be the type of soil below the seabed. Side scan survey means it will give what is the type of soil in the seabed, if there is any rocky patches, if there is any barge which has sunk, which is lying on the seabed, where is there any submerged outcrop of rock, all those things will be given by side scan survey. Technologically, we will be able to do everything ourselves. We do not need anybody to do all these surveys, it has been done for many projects. Once we complete this, then we prepare the detailed project report, which include certain studies like tranquility, shoreline evaluation, this I will discuss later. Then we have to do what is the impact of this shipyard facility on the environment, and if there are any undesirable impact, what is the management plan what we have to rectify the impacts, that is what we will be doing. Then one of the important thing is CRZ, coastal regulation zone, this is the map which has to be provided to identify what is the high tide line and low tide line. So this we have to demarcate from the high tide line how much distance is 500 meters, 200 meters and other things. So if you have a high tide line, from the high tide line up to 500 meters you cannot have any residential facility, hotel facility and all, whereas harbor facility can be planned from the high tide line. So this is very important. There are only few agencies which can do this CRZ mapping. One of them is Institute of Remote Sensing and Anna University, another is National Institute of Ocean Technology at Pallikaranai, Velachery, NIO Goa, CWPRS, like that about 7 agencies are identified to do this CRZ map. We cannot get it done from other agencies. So our shipyard layout has to be superimposed on the CRZ map, and then only there is a committee, Ministry of Environment and Forest. That committee will review all the documents and give the approval to carry out this project. So shipyard planning and development consists of two phases, one is the project preparation, another is project implementation. The project preparation involves concept development and master planning. Our institute IIT Madras, we are also preparing a master plan. Originally also there was a master plan, now we are revising. So the master plan is very much required for any project. Then we have to prepare the preliminary project report, we have to carry out the topography and pathymetry survey, we have to do the site survey and detailed project report preparation. Site survey is seismic survey and site scan survey. Then we have to carry out feasibility studies to assess the suitability of the site for the shipyard. Then we have to carry out the environmental studies. Then we have to prepare the layout, schedules, cost estimate, and we have to submit the reports to various statutory authorities. There are two main statutory authorities. One is the central government, which is Ministry of Environment and Forest. There is another approval which has to be obtained from the state government, that is Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board, for the purpose of Tamil Nadu state. The Tamil Nadu Pollution Control Board has another committee which finally gives the consent to operate. That certificate is required so that they can start the operation. These are the two agencies to which you have to approach and get the clearances. This shows the area which will be developed. Earlier I have shown 5 meter, 10 meter and 15 meter contour. The survey was taken after the tsunami has hit the coast of Kadalur. If you see the contour, you can see that the contour is going like this, it is not straight line. So this is a peculiar feature of Kadalur Court, there is some geomorphological reason for getting this type of contours. It is going inside, normally the contours will be like a straight line like this, whereas it is going like this, this contour is shown here. There are 4 points marked here, A, B, C and D. These are the 4 control points which will be given by Tamil Nadu Maritime Board. Each state is supposed to have a maritime board, coastal state. Gujarat is the first state which had a maritime board, Gujarat Maritime Board, then Maharashtra Maritime Board, Tamil Nadu Maritime Board. None of the other states have maritime board. They are having a director of ports they don't have a maritime board. So it is essential that there is a maritime board in each state to regulate this. So what it means is this A, B, C, D, this area is given to this shipyard project. So whatever they want to do, they have to restrict their operation within this area. This is the shipyard which is planned inside the harbor. Maybe next slide will give some more details. So we have point A, northing and easting, that is given here, point B, point C, point D. The distances are also marked. Between A and B, it is about 6.3 kilometers, B and C is about 4.45, C and D is about 5.595, D and A is 4.41 kilometers. This is the area that is earmarked for this. Typically about 20 meter contour is the point where they give the offshore location. For harbor project, they give a distance of about 2 kilometers, for a shipyard they have given 4 kilometers. This shows the layout of the shipyard. What we are doing is, we are filling up this area like this by a north breakwater and by a south breakwater like this. Then we, the land area available is very less, land acquisition is a bigger problem. So they restrict the land area less by reclaiming the land on the sea. The original shoreline is here, they are reclaiming more than about 600 meters here. So whatever they do, the dredging, this material will be used for reclamation of this land. There are two breakwaters which are built, and then we have the entrance channel, turning circle. There is a dock basin here, there is another dock basin here. There are three berths for outfitting, there are two berths. These two berths will be utilized for import of steel materials. The flow will be like this, they will take it here, and from here one ship will come. These also two facilities to import the raw material, and then there will be a flow here and they will build the ship here. The under keel portion below the water level will be done in the dry docks, whereas the outfitting above the water level will be done at these locations. Is it clear? There are two dry docks, the ships will be built in these two dry docks. There are two import terminals to get the steel plates, either from India or from abroad, mostly from abroad. There should be a flow of materials. You have plate cutting yard or pipe bending yard, and then modular fabrication. Modular means they will not build the ship everything in the dry dock. The ship weight is, let us say, about 20,000 tons. They will build 10 blocks each of 2,000 tons, and then they will bring it here so that the time required for building a ship will be less than a month. You have to build 28 ships. So each dry dock will build 14 ships each. So we will not do all the shipbuilding inside the dry dock. Whatever portion is above the water level, that is called as outfitting, that will be done in this portion. So when you build a turning circle here and a entrance channel, the waves will be coming from different directions. We have to find out whether the waves are less inside this harbor basin. And when you build the breakwater like this, the southern side there will be an accretion, northern side there will be an erosion. So you have to assess how much erosion will be there, and suitable remedial measures are to be taken. Then the transport network, the railway station is at Alappakkam, and the shipyard can be reached by a feeder line. You have to lay a line from Alappakkam to the shipyard location. The National Highway 45 passes close to the proposed site. The nearest airport is at Chennai, but now we have, they have commissioned an airport at Pondicherry also. Airport is also an essential requirement, not only for the people to visit. There are certain essential components which are very expensive, like equipments inside the ship. All these things will be airlifted. 90% only will come by ship, other 10% will come by air cargo only. The environmental impact assessment, what is this EIA means? So we have to first identify the activities involved in the proposal and associated deepening of the port basin and navigation channel. What we do is, we artificially develop a harbor basin by building a breakwater, that is one of the component. Then we deepen the existing seabed so the bigger vessels can come. So these two aspects has to be very clearly established, then you have to identify because of this what are the impacts and the risk associated with the proposed development. One of them is the risk analysis and disaster management. This has different components, both onshore as well as the offshore activities. Then CRZ classification, the disposal study of dredge material, that is when you want to dredge the material, where are you going to dispose it of. Then littoral drift. Littoral drift means there will be some accretion on one side and erosion on the other side, that has to be done. Then maneuvering and tranquility study. Maneuvering means when you want to bring the vessel, one of the class I told it should come in the head sea or following sea condition. If not, they have to find out how to maneuver the vessel in other conditions. Tranquility study means when the ship is inside the harbor basin, the wave height should be preferably less than 0.3 meter to 0.5 meter. Even outside is 3 to 5 meter, inside should be only 10% of that. That is tranquility study. These two studies are not giving the same kind of layout. For tranquility, you may need a different layout. For maneuvering, better maneuvering, you may need a different layout. This point you should understand. Both the purposes are different. For maneuvering, the layout may be different from tranquility, but you have to come to a compromise. The best layout may not satisfy 100% maneuvering and 100% tranquility. If you see the harbor basin here, some of the areas here and here, it may have better tranquility. This berth also may have better tranquility, whereas other berths may not have better tranquility. When the ship is coming this direction, for some waves which are coming from south during south east monsoon, southwest monsoon, this will be in beam sea condition, but the wave heights are smaller in southwest monsoon. So that time we have to use more tugboats to bring the vessel inside. What are the major systems and components in the shipyard? We have two dry docks, one is the northern side, another is the southern side. We want to have 500 meter by 100 meter by 10 meter and another is 600 meter by 70 meter by 9 meter. The harbor basin size is with a larger draft of 14 meter. This larger draft is required because once you build the vessel and then bring it outside, then we may ballast it and then take it for trials outside, and when a bigger vessel comes for repair, they will come to the harbor basin, then they will deballast and bring it inside the dry dock. Turning circle, typically twice the length of the ship we need with a larger depth. Entrance channel length should be about 7 times the length of the vessel that is provided. The south breakwater is 1400 meter and north breakwater is 1000 meter. The length of the breakwater, if it is more, the cost will be more. Here the bathymetry is very close to the shoreline. If you see the ancient ports in Tamil Nadu, they are located either at Kadalur or at Nagapattinam, because at these two locations the 10 meter contour is very close to the shoreline. This is one of the reason why we have to locate this shipyard in Kadalur. Then we are providing some coastal protection wall on the south side and north side to take care of the coastline erosion. The quantity of dredging is about 15 million cubic meter. The outfitting berths are about 7 numbers. We need steel stockyard and pipe store. We need a gantry crane which can lift up to 800 tons each model. Then we need an overhead crane. We need hull shop, assembly shop, advanced outfit and modular fabrication shop, robotized welding, allied infrastructure facilities, automation in application. All the things are required for the shipyard. One of the reason our shipyards are not developed is the government is not subsidizing any of this shipyard construction, whereas China, most of the shipyards are government owned and they give lot of subsidy. The subsidy in two parts, one subsidy is for the ships built for China, another subsidy is for dumping the ships abroad. So the cost of the ship which they want to sell abroad will be at least 20% cheaper than what they are selling inside China. 20% will be given by the government. Then in addition, we need this township and associated facilities including schools, hospitals, and we also need water to all the ships. We need a drainage system and also a desalination plant and sewage treatment plant. These are all the components of a shipyard facility. With this, we are ending this. Any doubts? Any questions? Nothing. Everything is clear. Telling that ship, we have skilled the manpower. We are having lot ancillary the car. So why not the ship? This is what they are telling. Only thing is we are not competitive in shipbuilding. If you have to be compete, the volumes are important. So I have given a picture of shipyard development which is not growing well, whereas we are able to develop many ports. So this is a preliminary project report for development of an all weather port at Bahudamugan, Sonapur in Orissa. This place is very close to Andhra border. The various facilities that are required for development of port is explained in this particular slide. The Orissa government has identified this particular location with this latitude and longitude for development of the port up to 20 meter contours. This shows the satellite imagery where the port will be developed. This is, there are different layouts of port. This particular port will be called as a lagoon harbor. Lagoon means we develop a training circle somewhere here, so the berthing facilities will be constructed along this line. We will build one breakwater here and another breakwater here. This is only to create a entrance channel, whereas the whole harbor will be developed inside this area. Lot of land is available here. Already this mouth is open most of the times in a year. And the contour also very close to the shoreline, 10 meter contour. This much land is also available. That is why we want to develop. So here it will be a lagoon harbor. All the facilities will be prepared, will be inside this land area. Orissa government has identified many locations all along the coast where they can develop the facility. So this is the place what we are talking about, Sonapur. There should be a master plan for development of port in Orissa also. They have identified about 10 locations to develop the port in Orissa. One of the class we studied about the tidal levels. So we should know what are the tidal variations. The mean high water spring is 1.7, mean low water spring is 0.7. That means the tidal range is 1 meter in spring tide and the tidal range is 0.4 meter in neap tide. This is the layout of the harbor. So we have a small breakwater here on the northern side. We have another breakwater on the southern side. From 15 meter contour, we are putting a entrance channel and a training circle. Then we have the harbor basin here and we are putting about 5 berths along these lines. This is the 5 meter, 10 meter and 15 meter contour and 20 meter contour. So they have fixed 4 points which will be given as the locations for port limits. These are called as the port limit. So within the port limit, another port will not come. The distance to 20 meter contour on the northern side is very large, about 3554 meter along this line, and this is only about 1943 meters. So this location, the 20 meter contour is very nearby. We need 2 breakwaters, one on the north side, another on the south side. sometimes you may have 3 breakwaters also. We need 5 cargo berths, each of length 300 meters, and this is being developed for 30 million tons. That means each berth will handle 6 million tons. To have a simple arithmetic, 1 million ton you can develop greenfield. Greenfield means nothing is there, you are just starting and then developing a port. The cost will be between 60 crores to 100 crores, that is a range of cost. If it is 60 crores, it is very you can do it for liquid cargo and the profit margin will be very high. If it is 100 crore, still you will have a profit margin, but it will not be as high as for a liquid cargo. So 60 cargo is for liquid cargo and 100 crores is for bulk cargo like iron ore, coal and all. We need this backup space 1500 meter by 500 meter, that means this is about 75 hectares that are required. The total length is 1500 meters and back side we need about 500 meters. This is the minimum requirement, and I am going to give you the cost estimate for this also. We will just have some idea how the cost is. The length of the breakwaters are given. North breakwater is for a small length, south is for a longer length. The top level of the breakwater is fixed at plus 7 meters. We have to plan the breakwater. This I will discuss separately, how the breakwater is. It has different layers. One is a bedding layer, toe mound, core layer, armor layer and tetrapod. That is, armor layer is using a tetrapod of 18 tons each weight. So this bed level is here, and on top of the bed level generally we give a filter layer, then we give what is known as a toe mound, then we put a core layer, then we put a under armor layer or called as simply under layer, then we put a armor layer, then we have a road width. Generally it is 8 meters. The slope is 1:2 or 1:1.5. So basically this is called as a rubble mound breakwater. This consists of a filter layer. In this area it is sand. On top of the sand we cannot pick a bigger size stones. What we do is we pick a slightly bigger size stone here. This is about 10 millimeter to 10 kg stone. Then we put the core material, 1 kg to 1000 kg stones. Then we put a under layer which is 1 ton to 2 ton stone. Then we put a specially made armor blocks, not made of stone, concrete units. This armor layers, depending on the water depth, it will vary from 2 tons to 18 tons. Smaller water depth may be 2 tons, bigger water depths it may be 18 tons. This is how we have to build the breakwater. We will discuss about the design of breakwater most probably before the first case. You will get a there is a formula called as Hudson's formula. We will be calculating the weight of the stone. I told the armor stone weight has to be calculated. So there is a formula using which we will calculate the armor stone. The width of the berth is generally about 23 meters because the crane has 2 rails. The rail spacing is about 18 meters. Front the rail should be 2.5 meter, and back also we need some space. There will be conveyor belts also to transport the cargo. So normally we have one typical berth. This berth will be about 300 meters by 23 meters. We have a crane rail, another crane rail. Typically they put 2 cranes, sometimes they will put 3 cranes also. There is a center line of the crane. This is another center line of the crane. The crane will have 2 legs on the sea side, 2 legs on the land side. Let us say that this is the sea side. Similarly here also we will have 4 legs. The spacing between them is 18 meter from here to here it should be greater than 2.5 meters, because we have to put the fenders and bollards, that is why this gap should be more. So, you need some space behind also for accessing this. So, this is one crane, this is another crane, each crane is having 4 legs, each leg they have 6 to 8 wheels. This side you may have number of wheels more, 8 to 12 wheels also will be there. The wheel load will be approximately about 50 tons. This is a vertical load and you may have lateral load also. This distance to, between the center to center may be around 17 meters. So, depending on this rail spacing, your width of the berth is decided. Each crane will can handle about 2000 tons per hour. We need a conveyor system behind the berth to transport to the stockyard. So, this is the 1500 meters by 500 meters stockyard which is planned here. There are various facilities required here, signal station, fire and safety, stockyards, port office, workshop, administrative building, substation, area for railway siding, canteen, hospital, customs, residential area. All these facilities are required for a port development with a backup area of about 75 hectares. The ship size is the main parameter to design the port facility. The ship size what we want to design is 100,000 DWT. This is something wrong, overall length is about 268 meters, width is 42.5 meters, height is, height means molded depth is 20.4 meters and the fully laden draft is 13 meters. We can handle a smaller size than this also, but generally we cannot handle bigger than this. We need a turning circle which is about twice the length of the ship, 268 means 2 to 2.5 times, and then dredge depth is 15 meters, approach channel details also are given here. The side slope is when you are dredging, what happens to the bottom? Suppose you have the water level here, this is the chart datum 00 level. Suppose your bed level is let us say at one location is minus 5, it may vary up to minus 15. At minus 5, you have to dredge like this, and this width is 250 meters and the depth required will be 15 meter. We have to assume a slope, this slope is 1 vertical to 5 horizontal. So, this much area we have to remove the soil, so that the ship will come in this, within this width of the channel. Typically the width of the channel is equal to length of the ship. Here we are showing the railway lines. This is the feeder line which will be connecting it to one of the main station here. This is the Berhampur. This is the main line which is going. And we also have I think this is your national highway, which is very close to this. Gopalpur is another port which is being developed now. This will be very close to this, maybe about 30 to 40 kilometers south of this. So, here we are giving some of the cost estimates. I will spend some time on this. This breakwater, north breakwater, is only up to 5 or 6 meter contour. The per meter length of the breakwater, it is called as a black cost estimate, is about 6 lakhs per running meter. Multiply by the length of the breakwater, you get the total cost. South breakwater, I think it goes up to 10 meter contour. I have put approximately 10 lakhs per running meter. I put 6 meter mean 6 lakhs and 10 meter mean 10 lakhs. It comes like that, but depending on the site situation it may vary. If the soil is not good, the cost may even double. Then we have this berth, 300 meter by 23 meter into 5 numbers. The area is 34,500 square meter. The cost of the berth per square meter is 70,000 rupees. What is the cost per square meter of any building? Civil engineers, cost of construction. You want to build your own house, don't ask me any question. What will be the estimate per square meter or per square feet? 2000 per square feet or square meter? I think you are having lot of money. You don't know the current market rate. I am not asking about the cost of the land and other things. You cannot build a house. You can build only a toilet. 2000 is near, but it is on a higher side. What is it? 1500 is close by. I am building a house, I am paying only 1300 rupees per square feet. Madras only. Chennai only. Cost of construction in IIT campus is around 2000 rupees per square feet. In IIT campus, around 2000 rupees per square feet. That is about 20,000 rupees per square meter. What is the cost of a house in Adyar or Kottaburam, or what will be the cost including the land? Cost including, if you want to buy a flat, what will be the cost? You cannot buy. You can buy 5000 in beyond Madavakkam, beyond Solinganallur. Adyar, Besant Nagar, Kottaburam, it is 15,500 rupees per square feet. What is it? Being developed, 15,000. See, you know Adyar, Coronet, we are building a flat quadrant opposite to Coronet Hotel. The cost is 15,500 rupees per square feet, almost double the cost of this berthing facility. So here it is 70,000 rupees per square feet. Excluding land, this is only construction cost, because you have 15 meter water depth, 5 meter top level, 20 meter, that means it is equivalent to 6 story building. So you take 1500 into 6 means 9000 rupees per square feet, that is 90,000 rupees per square meter. Is it clear why the cost is high? Because the height is more. The backup area development is given here, it is a very less cost only. Then approach road and rail connectivity, I think we have given a lump sum cost, kilometer cost, 1 kilometer is 2 crores. This is 1 kilometer is 2.2 crores. Railway siding, this dredging is about 200 rupees per cubic meter if it is sand. This cost is very high, this is in lakhs, it is 400 crores dredging. Total cost, other everything put together is 1500 crores approximately. 1500 crores for 30 million tons is only 50 crores per million ton. But one of the problem, the catch is you may not get 30 million tons initially. Even if you develop a berth, you may not have the cargo potential initially. Over a period of time it will come. But this is a very good location where you can build the facility. I think there is I think I have not discussed about the harbor crane. Each crane is about 20 crores. Then conveyor is 1.5 lakhs per running meter. You have 5 kilometer of conveyor system. So there are mechanical engineers, you have only for 275 crores what you can sell. You can include some part of the dredging, which is about 400 crores. Where is that dredging? This is the dredging. All other things are civil engineers only, port engineers. So in a project, approximately 30% will go for mechanical works, balance 70% for civil engineers. think some more things are missed, I don't know. Okay. Conclusion. The proposed location of the site near Sonapur in this river Bagudamugan south of Gopalpur is suitable for development due to following advantages. Draft is deeper, dredging is less and hence cost is low. 400 crores dredging is a very less cost. For some of the ports we have to do even 1000 crores. Port location is free from mangroves. So, if you have mangroves then it is not desirable to have, you will not get a permission. Enough backup area is available, road and rail connectivity is near the port location and the project can be completed in about 36 months. These are some of the reasons for developing this. So, in future classes what we will be studying is mainly about the design of the berth, design of the breakwater, dredging and other ancillary facilities. Thank you.